About 10 years ago, I made a pact with myself that I would never eat anything out of season, however tempting it might be. And now I look forward to the coming of a new potato, to the English asparagus season, to tomatoes when they come, however late in the year they happen to ripen. And I think seasonal food is very important, because all this stuff you buy in the supermarkets is chilled and irradiated and kept. I had a letter once from a journalist for one of the nastier tabloid newspapers, and he said, my father is a Ayrshire dairy, potato farmer. He said, it's been so wet, there hasn't been a single potato planted this year, this was a few years ago, yet. And he said, but one of the major supermarkets, I think it was Safeway or something, was selling Ayrshire earlies. He said, and there can't be any Ayrshire earlies. So I started doing some investigation. In those days, I wrote a column. And sure enough, what they were was the previous season's salad potatoes, so they were small, which had been chilled and irradiated and overwintered. Now, if you put a potato in a cupboard, even a dark cupboard, it will start sprouting, won't it? Sooner or later it will sprout. Well, I bought some of these things and I put them in a cupboard in my house, and then I took them out of the cupboard and put them in the light, and they never, never, never sprouted. Everything sprouts in my house, but they never sprouted. So I think it's terribly important. You can get all these chefs, and they all pay lip service to seasonal food, and then you go to their restaurants, and there's asparagus in September, you know, something like that. Mm. So I feel very strongly about seasonal food, and if we all made that self-same pact not to buy vegetables out of season, fruit out of season. When I was a child, olive oil was sold in chemist shops for external use only. Not to be taken internally. The only place you could buy olive oil in London was in Soho, in the Italian shops, outside chemists. And, look at the different types of olive oil now and the huge marketing of olive oil. And that was all public pressure. You know, public pressure is enormously powerful, but we just don't use it. You know, as a nation, we don't stamp our feet, we don't complain. And we should, because I'm quite convinced that the huge increase in cancer in modern times has been partly because of all the additives in food. The nut allergies. I have a goddaughter whose husband is so nut allergic, he comes from Dorset, that she can't eat nuts for 24 hours before she kisses him. I said, you're giving up nuts, obviously. They haven't been married that long. And what a way to get fed up with the husband. But I'm convinced that all this increase in nut allergies is largely due to all the hidden nuts that they use as bulk. The same with, gluten allergies and things. It's all the hidden agendas within cheap food. And I knew somebody whose husband he'd been an RSPCA dog catcher, and he was sacked for standing up and saying that their 5 million campaign against hunting and whatever wouldn't save the life of a single fox or a single deer, and would have spayed every feral cat in the country. And they lived, because he had a lurcher, for 6 months until he got another job on rabbit, which he said he made rabbit bolognese, rabbit stir fry. The children didn't really know what they were eating, but they're perfectly happy with it. She said, we bury 40 tons of rabbit a year in landfill sites. So it's all about education, you're absolutely right. And unfortunately, I think it was my generation who were so busy burning their bras and wanting to be out there being sort of not seen as domestic goddesses that did the real damage. So that, you know, there was a gap where people didn't learn to cook from their mothers. And you know, all we get on television is chef's programs. Well, that's not going to teach a child anything, is it? And all these CBB programs they do all these really sort of wimpy things. And nobody does a cookery program for television. And there's a thought. Why don't you all write to the BBC and tell them we should have children's cookery programs and CBBs? Yes?